Okay, so this is a little video on how to remove your deck from a Cub Cadet LTX 1046. This is with the Kawasaki engine, and sharpen your blades and put the deck back on. So it's a 46 inch deck, non-mulching, and you should do this very often and not allow grass to collect. You can see I'm the worst offender. I don't do it as often as I should. But it's actually a fairly easy process. So, first thing you want to do is remove this pin from the front of the deck and the washer as well. And we'll put that aside so we don't lose it. Then we want to lower the deck so that it's at its lowest position down on the ground. Now I can remove this guide that pulls the deck along with the tractor. That comes out very easily. Then on both sides of the back of the deck, there are pins that hold the deck in place. So we're just going to pull straight out those until they come loose from the adjustment, and you can slide them around towards the back so that it'll hold them out from the carriage that holds it in place. I'll do the same thing on the other side, pull that out straight away. And then I can lift the carriage on the tractor to pull that out of the way. Now I'm going to slide the deck forward on either side towards the front of the tractor. So that's one side. And slide the other side forward. I guess my pin went back in the hole. Okay, so that is free. We can slide the whole carriage forward, the whole deck forward, and then remove the belt from the pulley. So that is a little tight around these guides. And so that bracket can be removed with, there's a half inch bolt, I'm not sure if you can see it here, on either side. And they just need to be removed. So I'll do that next. So I have a half inch socket wrench with an extension. I'm just going to remove that bolt on the one side. And with that bolt out, that gives me enough room to just kind of bend out that bracket enough to get the belt around it. So there's enough space there. I can get that out. I'll do the same thing on the other side. Again, I'm going to loosen up that bolt. Just enough that I can get that bracket loose and get the belt around. Off, and you can see the bracket fell right down, so that's loose. The whole deck is now loose, so as I said, I'm going to take the bracket off out of the way for now. Put that aside. Now the deck is loose, so I can slide it out towards me. Mm-hmm. gonna want to clean all the grass off of that, and also just make sure that you know how your belt goes in case that comes undone. So if you get a picture of that for yourself, that's good. Now I'm gonna flip over the deck and we'll take off the blades. So I put a block of wood in there to keep the blade from spinning, and it's a 15/16 inch bolt there. Go ahead and try to get that off. It did require a bit of an extension pipe to get it loose, but a little bit of force and I was able to get it free. Take that side off. And now take the other side off. And you may want to mark the blade some way that it will remind you of where it goes. So this one I'm going to put a C because it's on the chute side. So there's the chute and this is the one on the other side. And it'll also be the part facing up, which is actually down once the deck is in the right position. So the other one, I can put whatever I want. I'll put an N for non-chute. And then I can pull those off. So it turns out these blades are symmetrical, both sides, so I didn't really need to say which one was on a chute side and which one was on a non-chute side, but it's not a bad idea to do that anyway. So sharpen them with your favorite method. I'm using a Tormach wet wheel, but you can read on the internet, there's many advantages and disadvantages to using different methods, be it freehand with a file or a dry wheel or whatever. This is convenient for me and seems to do a decent job. By the way, the grind angle on these was about 45 degrees, between 40 and 45 degrees. They're not perfect, there's still a few nicks in them. They were kind of beat up, but they're much sharper than they were, and that'll translate into much less wear and tear on the tractor because it'll cut through the grass easily rather than chopping at it. Now we're going to reinstall them and put the deck back on the tractor. Now while I have the blades off, I can scrape some of this grass off the bottom. I like to use a piece of wood that just has a bevel cut into it. That won't damage anything, but it does a pretty good job of scraping off the stuck grass. This deck is not too bad this time. Sometimes I have a lot of grass stuck on here, but this one's not too bad. You can just go around and clean it up as good as you want. I've even been known to use pressure washer sometimes, and that loosens up very heavy stuff. I put the blades back on. The end, it's the not chute side, and the C, which is the chute side, wherever the C is, right there. And I'm going to tighten those down. I noticed when I turned it back over that anywhere the grass could get stuck, it did. So what I'm going to do is take these plastic covers off the spindles and clean out as much of that as I can. It requires a 3/8 inch socket to pull that off, and they come off pretty easily. You can see that the grass is just caked all in there, and I'm gonna go ahead and pull that out by hand as much as I can. And that's much cleaner. I'll do the same thing on the other side after I reattach the cover. The other side is equally caked up, so I'll get all the grass out of there and also the grass out of these middle two wheels. Now I'm gonna slide the deck back under. Get it about approximately in position. Try to put that belt back over the pulley. And then we're going to put that bracket back on. Okay, now this is the most difficult part of the job, but I've figured out a trick that helps. So you have to get this pin here lined up with this hole, but it's spring-loaded to tension the belts under there. So there is a tensioning screw down there which you can loosen and you know with a wrench to give yourself more room, but I've thought of a way that seems to work really well. So what I do is I take either a come along, or in this case I use one of these ratcheting straps, tie down straps, to pull the deck back towards the edge of the bracket so that the holes line up. So what I do is attach it to some strong piece. You could attach it right down to the hitch, or I find it easier to attach it up there at the top of the metal. And then I'm going to take the other end and attach it underneath the deck, just something sturdy and, if possible, as close to the middle so that it'll pull the deck pretty evenly front to back. So it's attached right under the deck, and there's the pulley, ratcheting pulley, and it's attached up there. So what I'm going to do is start to tighten that and pull the deck back towards that hole. It should pop right in because it's spring loaded if you have the level set. If it goes above or below, you can adjust your deck leveler until it's hitting at the right spot. We have to do the same thing on the other side. And that side's in. Easy peasy Japanesey. Now we're going to just reattach this pin through here, bar through there, and washer and pin, flip that over, and we're all set. One last detail. So I noticed when I was putting it all back together, there was a spring dangling down here. So I looked in the manual. I didn't see any place that the other end of it's supposed to go to. The first end was hanging off of a clutch plate, and I didn't see any place obvious on the frame that it was supposed to connect to. I fortunately have a neighbor who has the exact same tractor. We actually even bought them together at the same time, and I went over and looked at his, and they just have it dangling or tensioning off of the frame right here. So I'm just going to pull that back on and make sure that that's good and secure. So there's a spring hanging on there. And we're all set to start her up and try it out. So I'm going to just go ahead and start it up. I'll do the narrating before I do so. The choke is here. And I'm going to turn the key. And then I'll pull the power takeoff and just make sure that the blades spin. Everything sounds normal. So that's it. Everything works well, and that's all we need to do. Thanks for watching.